get her more. Make sure you get a nice job. We're going to go look.
Let's go. Knocking on the canopy and the front fender. welcome to my show. My name is Bud, and I'm here to entertain, educate, and amaze, for I am an audio animatronicated figure. I'd like to introduce my assistant. He's a robot. I call him Tiger. Come on, Tiger. Help me entertain the nice people. Tiger! He's a little shy. See, folks, I'm in the showbiz since I was a man, but you two present. I taught him everything he knows. Tiger! Conducting the Detroit Phil Robotic Orchestra. Maestro.
Underwater.
Wrong, Rover.
Oh, man.
It's judgment. You must use good judgment. And what else must you do, Scott?
Swim safely, follow your diving rules,
and never horse around while diving.
Instantly over long distances. Signals and voices. To manage this growing storehouse of information, we invent the computer, a revolutionary tool made practical by the tiny transistor. In the technologies of communications and computers to store, process, and share information. And we're creating a vast electronic network stretching from our homes to the reaches of space.
Okay, Atlanta. We'll begin testing now and we'll call you back.
To the platform up ahead. The platform and your vehicle are traveling at equal speed.
Up there, though.
It looks like a mohawk.
Yeah. startling idea can lead to even more. So many times, we're stumbling in the dark, and then, eureka!
Y'all gonna turn around?
My name is David Sparling. I'll be your show announcer for this afternoon.
Mastercraft ProStar, manufactured in Maryville, Tennessee. Highly skilled, highly trained professionals behind the wheels of all the Mastercrafts. Placing well over 255 horsepower. From south to north, left to right. Nice box. Rossinelli, Keith Campbell, the professional power wheel drivers. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is David Sparling. It's my pleasure to be your host for the first The Ski Show.
If you share our dreams, if you love to walk, there's only one place to be. So you keep on trying. Kids from all across America, heading to the lakes and rivers.
Just a few,
like the red, the white, and the blue.
swords or some sort of a boat. Porky, it's a boat, not a submarine. All right, another great moment in water ski history. Porky got it. Now it's twice in neutral. 2 minutes and lead up to 360 degrees all the way around the towboats. Hang on, gentlemen. South lost again. That's a good start. And if that's your right ski, the other ski is, of course, your wrong ski. Yes, all right, there you go. Grab a hold of the handle and get a grip on a grip. Say, Todd, hit it! Todd, hit me. Well, all right. Corky, there you go. Corky, pull yourself together, will you? Pull the act together. Thank you. All right, now, folks down there at the door skating, Corky's going to come on back around there. What's the matter, Donnie? There's a boat in the way. Right. How many recreational water to try it behind a boat? Down here in the South Stadium Beach, once again, it's our hometown boy, Joel Baker. He's back this time to show us what is known as the sliding beach start. Off onto the water surface, he's ready to go for it. 38 miles an hour. He digs his feet in the champion waters, and away he goes. Front barefooting champion, Joel Baker. The flying dock start. He throws himself out and onto the water surface on his face and chest. The boat speed for this one, folks, 40 miles an hour. And he is, just losing the handle out there. Spinning back around, he says one more time. Now, I don't want to make any excuses here, but once again, tries to get up to the speed of 40 miles an hour. Brian attempts to plan his speed and just can't make it. Ladies and gentlemen, Brian Boisard with an excellent effort out there. Some choppy waters out there in Lake Eloise today. Not let's go, the two-ski jump out. All right, guys, one, two, three. We've got three up. Well, there you go, we're going out the front early. It's Robert Borgiana against Brian Winker off through the front stretch. Into the first corner they go. Who will it be? Brian Winker, looks like he might be in some trouble. Robert Borgiana has turned himself around. Cypress Point, no ordinary bear hunter. This young man is extraordinary, ladies and gentlemen. Into the front stretch, he's still hanging on backwards. Over 1/3 of a mile on his bare feet, he is still going. National barefooting champion, Robert Borgiana. He was so infatuated with the girls in the ski show that unsolicited he wrote this song.
In Cypress Cuts, a man in Aquaman. Cute as she can be. When she glides along on her water skis, it sure makes a wreck of me. Now when the sun goes down on that tropical island, everything went well. My gal comes out and to my surprise is dressed like a southern belle. Aquamane, oh Aquamane, Aquamane, my Aquamane. You ski so fine and so full of life. I'm a guy, you can be my wife. Now I've traveled here and I've traveled there. No spot did I see. A more beautiful place, oh, my lovely girl. So welcome here, come with me. I'm a guy, you can be my wife. Now I've traveled here and I've traveled there. No spot did I see. A more beautiful place, oh, my lovely girl. So welcome here, come with me.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Cypress Gardens Aquamane!
Man, I wonder, gliding on the sea, with your favorite pose, your paradise on skis. Oh,
kite, this is what we're stuck with.
I should have told Corby that turkeys can't fly.
Well, I don't think he would have paid any attention anyway.
He doesn't look anything like a right brother. He looks more like a... All together now, everybody. He looks more like a...
Wrong
brother. Yes, that's right.
No, that's wrong. Well, now I'm confused.
Oh, well.
You know...
Flying on a wing and a prayer, and that is no tail. Ladies and gentlemen, the one only, the unsinkable, Corky the Clown. Well, while Corky's been clowning around out there, we've been preparing our single most awe-inspiring act of the show, the flight of the Delta Wing Kite, on our South Stadium stage, Brian Boisard, about to go into liftoff, his wingman, Mr. Joel Baker. Joel holding that wing stable. Very, very strong headwind, Brian will be going into in just a few moments. 500 feet of tow line in that basket before him. Enough to take Brian 480 feet above the water surface. We have a liftoff. Towed out above the waters of Lake Eloise, he communicates with his boat driver by a series of kick signals. Brian wants to accelerate, he simply drops his right leg forward. Wants to slow down, he spreads his legs apart and holds them there. And when he reaches maximum altitude, he crisscrosses his legs back and forth in a scissor-like motion. This tells the boat driver to bring the boat to a complete stop. Our second kite pilot to the far south, Jeff Stoskov, preparing his Delta Wing kite for liftoff. Now, as we look out above the water, you just might have caught Brian Boisard with his signal. Boat comes to a complete stop. He's on his own. Free flight. Among the top five kite pilots in the world today, the assistant ski show director, High Flying Brian Boisard.
Hold up. Jack Pro Star, a 21-year powerboat driving veteran. He's known as the Dean. Ladies and gentlemen, Russell Bailey. From south to north, Brian Boisard, Robert Porgiana, Darren Dobson, and David Dunn, the Ramp Masters.
The clowns over here on the south stage, Dave. God, Dave. Thanks, Dave.
Trash in the past wasn't enough. Now the little guy is back to the future. Corky in space.
Yeah, what concept?
Look, Corky, if you're an astronaut, you're gonna need a co-pilot, buddy. You got a co-pilot? Ah, there she is, folks. It's Corky's long-lost love, Torquette.
Isn't she pretty?
Yeah, she's pretty ugly.
No, I'm sorry, Torquette. Sorry you're so ugly.
All right, look, Torquette, turn around.
No, I'll tell you what. Turn a square. There you go. Now sit down. Alrighty.
And we got them. Corky and Corkette about ready to blast into outer space. And there you go. Well, Corkette, I'm sorry about that. He ruined your hair doing everything. Look, I'll have to come on back and apologize to you, alright? Look, that's Keith Campbell out there. That's Jimmy's brother. He's our substitute boat driver. I don't really think he knows what's going on. Look, Keith takes to the air.
Corky, you're supposed to jump.
Jump!
No, you're an astronaut. Let's see a moonwalk.
You're not bad. You're playing terrible. Keith, beam him up. Beam him up, Keith.
Thanks. I think Corky got the point out of that one.
All right, look, Corky's gonna come on by, and you can give him a piece of your mind, but don't give him too much, you know.
You really don't have much to spare.
To have Corkette got so carried away, she
actually got carried away. You see that?
Oh, man, it's gonna be spectacular. This time he's really gonna go for it. He's going!
Well, right now, folks, I'm going to direct your attention to the South Stadium takeoff. You might hear something. What? Launch as our skiers take to the stage of water and work to build it up.
cocaine, synchronize, woman! All right! Lisa Mani, Pat Picard! Back Worcester and a front Worcester!
Dedication time. A dedication. Now, who are you going to dedicate your dive to?
Mother-in-law.
To your mother-in-law? Where is she?
Where is the old bag? Yes, she is. In the white shirt. Hi, Ma. This is for you. Because I love you. Go.
Hey, what's that? Look out. Oh, no. Hey, they're everywhere. Hey, you guys. Call it.
Oh.
Hey, you guys all right? You need to get down from there. You heard me. I said, get down! Not exactly what I meant, folks, when I said get down. Oh, look out. That guy just got down. Hey, you two guys. Lady, get off his back!
So good.
Hey, Mom, get off there. So look out.
Ooh.
Not this group again. I don't
know if I can handle this.
Okay, okay, wait, right. Hey, hold on, hold on. Way out of hand. Hey! Hey, buddy, what are you doing up there?
I go to the top.
Go to the top. Nobody, hey, buddy. Oh, my God! You can hurt yourself up there.
Oh.
Hey, you almost gave me a heart attack. Get down from there. Involved in this dive, we ask for your total and complete silence, please. The spray that you're about to see will serve as a focal point for Pat. When he approaches the water, he'll be approaching a speed of nearly 75 miles per hour on impact.
One of the most photographed areas of the garden, so if you have a camera, you might want to get it ready.
That's why she's sitting there.
Look at the bird.
Coming up here to your right, you'll see our gazebo, a weekly inspirational Day of Discovery filmed here every Easter. It's also called our love chapel because we held many weddings here. Coming up to your right, you'll see a waterfall. It's another famous.
You got the trees in front of you. It's called 100.
Right, it's pointing up to our traveler's palm. It's called a traveler's palm because early travelers used to tap the base of this palm and get a fresh quart of water every 48 hours. For this palm, your wish will come true within 1 year. Behind it is our twin-headed palm. And the small palm tree coming up to your right is called a pygmy date palm. Palm tree can reach over 100 years old and seldom exceeds the height of 10 feet. Gray sword-shaped plant to the left is called a gavi or century plant. It's called a century plant because it blooms every 100 years. Great Buddha of Japan's overlooking our Oriental rock garden, authentic lantern, seed house, and a variety of rare plants. The tree in front of you about to pass under is called our Chinese Weeping Elm. An old Chinese legend says if you pass under this tree and you're single, you'll never marry. A little stump like obvious to your right are called cypress knees. It gives the tree a breathing apparatus and also gives it support. And the tree knocked down off to right was stumped by a hurricane. It should live like that for another 12 years. Such as agriculture, medicine, and cosmetics. That concludes our tour for today. Hope you've enjoyed it. Please remain seated. The boat comes complete. Stop and exit one row at a time, starting with the first row. Enjoy the rest of your day here in beautiful Cypress Gardens. Thank you.
Stephanie.
Help Jennifer up.
Thank you.
tomorrow.
What is this?
A monkey.
A little monkey.
Did Jennifer have her fan? Was she holding it?
I think I've got it in my purse. Well, here's one.
Here's another. Mommy, look at it. That one looks like a dog. It does eat. It looks like a dog. It's a dog. Oh,
mommy. Hello.
Can you touch it?
And what is your name?
I'm going to pick it. Pick it mine.
Thank you. Airplane-like portion, approximately the size of a DC-9, is the orbs for cooling and sound suppression.
Now you'll notice there's no evidence of burning or smoke discoloration on the concrete of pad B.
Thank you. supposed to sit?
Stephanie, get back.
Daddy, not right, Stephanie.
Yep.
No, let's write it up now.
Doll, it's decoration. They didn't have a bumper sticker here.
I got my sticker.
Nope. She said that. Almost. Doug, are you taking movies with that?
Yep. He is. See that new button?
What? Quit putting your hand.
Mommy, they just said it upside down. That's me. Oh, my hand doing that. Mama made his glasses just fall off.
And what do we call that kind of arrangement, Johnny?
Barter system?
That's correct. Well, you do know your economics. However, you will wear that lunch cap until you learn.
Thank you.
Why does this thing stink?
I can't get him.
Goes
there.
pirates. They only have one eye and a peg leg. Never seen any pirates? Sure haven't seen any pirates? How about down there in Disneyland? See any pirates down there? You did see any pirates from Caribbean down there in Disneyland?
No? Yeah.
How about that? No, he's a soldier. He's another Spanish soldier. Get away. Get away, baby. There you go. Throw him a kiss. Throw him a kiss.
Por fuerte, as we say in Spanish. This time it was going to be a castillo, a castle, complete with stone walls, moats, and drawbridges. But
shut up.
ready in a minute. Jennifer, I'm changing your clothes. You got jelly all over your pants.
Definitely.